So good evening, fellow practitioners. Welcome back to Chanling Kundas, your online Zen practice hosted for you by Guanyin Chanling Zen Meditation Center, Singapore. 各位同修们，晚上好，欢迎回到禅林喜城，由Guanyin Chanling新加坡为您举办的上线禅修。So if you're practicing together action with us for the first time, tonight's practice will be as follows. We'll first begin with the chanting of the Prajna Paramita Heart Sutra in English, and we will dedicate this chanting for peace to earth and all sentient beings. Next, Chanling's abbot and guiding teacher, Gamun Sunim, also known as Venerable Chibun, will give us a Dharma talk. This week's topic is Chan Meditation Paramita. So Chan is also the word for Zen. Then we'll proceed to the question and answer session. So if you have any queries regarding the Dharma talk that Shifu is sharing with us this evening, please ask the question right here and now. Well, you know, the content of the Dharma talk is still fresh on the mind of all the practitioners here tonight. Otherwise, you know, if you have faced any issues in your personal practice this week, do feel free to take this opportunity to consult Shifu. Last but not least, we recite the four great vows to reaffirm to ourselves the direction of our practice. 那如果今晚是您第一次与我们修一起行动，今晚的禅修将如此的顺序展开。首先呢，我们会诵英文版的波略。波罗蜜多心经，祈愿地球跟众生平安。接着禅林住持与指导老师纪文师父会为我们做佛法开示。这周呢，师父带来的主题是禅波罗蜜。开示完，我们会进入问答环节。如果你对这期的开示有任何的疑问，请把握当下发问。这也可以帮助大家对这期的佛法开示还记得非常的清晰。那如果佛法开示没什么疑问的话，或者是你这个星期的自修有面对什么问题或疑问，也可以把握机会向师父请教。那最后呢，我们会念四弘誓愿，确定自己修行的方向，世世行菩萨道。 So we would like to encourage everyone to chant with our Dharma brother Yung Yue. So it's quite important to be able to perceive your voice at the same time, perceive Yung Yue's voice and perceive the sound coming out from the modak. This is the modak. And we hope, if you're not musically inclined, that's fine. You can just recite the word. The words of the sutra will appear on the screen as well. So take this as an opportunity to practice your Prajna Paramita Heart Sutra in English. Chanting is also one of our fundamental practice. 那我们诚心的鼓励大家跟着音乐一起诵这个英文版的心经，然后关照自己的声音，关照音乐的声音，还有关照木鱼的声音。So let's do it. 仔细去做。
那么Sarah, when practicing Dipita Prajna Paramita, perceived all five skandhas are empty, then is safe from all suffering and distress. Sariputra from Desnadifa from emptiness. Emptiness does not differ from that which is from is emptiness. That which is emptiness from the same is true of feelings, perceptions, impulses, consciousness. Sariputra, all dhammas are marked with emptiness. They do not appear or disappear, are not tainted or pure, do not increase or decrease. Therefore, in emptiness, no form, no feelings, perceptions, impulses, consciousness, no eyes, no ears, no nose, no tongue, no body, no mind, no color, no sound, no smell, no taste, no touch, no object of mind, no realm of eyes, and so forth unto no realm of mind consciousness, no ignorance, and also no extinction of it, and so forth unto no age and death, and also no extinction of them, no suffering, no origination, no stopping, no path, no cognition, also no attainment, with nothing to attain. The Bodhisattva depends on Prajna Paramita, and the mind is no hindrance, without any hindrance, no fears exist, far apart from every perverted view, and as in Nirvana, in the three worlds of Buddhas depend on Prajna Paramita, and attain Anuttara Samyak Sambodhi. Therefore, know that Prajna Paramita is the great transcendent mantra, is the great bright mantra, is the utmost mantra, is the supreme mantra, which is able to relieve all suffering, and is true, not false, so proclaim the Prajna Paramita mantra, proclaim the mantra which says Gate Gate Para Gate Para Sangate Bodhisattva, Gate Gate Para Gate Para Sangate Bodhisattva, Gate Gate Para Gate Para Sangate Bodhisattva.
So thank you, Ying Ye, for leading us in the chanting of the Prajna Paramita Heart Sutra. 那感谢Ying Ye带领我们一起诵英文版的《波略波罗蜜多心经》。So fellow practitioners, please pull our palms together and greet 师父 with one sitting bow. 各位从修们请合掌并向师父一问讯。
大家吉祥。
Hello everyone, I hope you're well. Thank you everyone for coming punctually to Chan Ling Queen Dust this evening.
很高兴的今天有机会跟大家一起在这里学习佛法。
I'm most delighted that we can come together and learn Buddha's teaching again this evening.
今天我们要跟大家讨论学习的就是六波罗蜜。
So tonight we're going to discuss and learn with everyone the six paramitas.
主要我们要讲禅波罗蜜。
So primarily, we want to talk about Chan Meditation Paramita.
禅师一个教导，只是现今更无实界。
So our Zen teachers, eminent Zen teachers of the past, has a teaching for us that is only now and no other time.
也就是说，我们所拥有的 只是当下,
which means all that we have is only this moment.
我们知道2020年很快就消失了。So
the year 2020 is going to disappear soon.
我相信每个人对2020年有一个很深的感受。So
I'm sure everyone has some deep impression about the year 2020.
我们先来分享这个一个马丁的教导。So
we want to share a teaching by Martin Buber, a Jewish philosopher.
他说你在世界的何方？
So it begins this way. Where are you in your world?
你拥有的岁月过了几年、几月、几天？
How many years, days of those allotted to you have passed.
而你来到什么地方?
And where have you gotten in your world?
也就是说你达到多远?
Which means how far along have you walked in your world?
通过这样的质问, 我们可以在某种程度上衡量出 自己走过的岁月的重量和色彩。
So through such self-inquiry, to a certain extent, we can gauge how meaningfully and how vibrantly have we lived our life.
有时候我们需要带着这样的问题来注视自己的生命。
So sometimes we need to self-inquire with such questions to observe our own life.
今年是怎么过的?
How did we live this year?
遇到怎么样的人?
Whom have we met?
哪些事情你遇到的人,你的心灵上的交流有多少?
So of those who you have met this year, how many do you make a deep connection with?
付出的心结究竟是为了谁?
All your efforts that you put in this year, what greater good is it for?
还是为了自己?
Or is it only just for yourself?
我们有必要去思考这些问题。
So it is necessary for us to contemplate on these questions.
通过这样的提问,
through such questionings,
我们每个人都会听到内心深处发出来的自己的声音。
Then each and every one of us can hear the true sound that emanate from deep within us.
同时也清楚了自己人生的价值和意义。
And we can become clear of our life values and purpose.
人生的价值和意义何在?
So, what is life's value and purpose?
我们要以反省去恶为学禅的起点。
So, we have to do self-reflection and get rid of our bad habit energy as the beginning point of Chan meditation practice.
我们如果不能把自己的错误去掉,
if we cannot get rid of our own mistakes.
而追求生命的解脱,
and also to pursue the liberation from the cycle of life and death.
那就是根佛法的因果法则违反了。
Then we are going against the law of cause and effect in Buddhism.
这个话怎么讲呢?
So what do we mean by that?
因为我们讲因果法则不是作为一种概念游戏。
So we say that the law of cause and effect is not some conceptual understanding, neither is it a game of life.
是叫我们知道而又无法下手去做，不是这样的。
Yet, although we understand the importance of the law of cause and effect, but we cannot get a hang of the practice.
我们了解因果法则，就是要我们在日常生活中一步一步地去试取。
So understanding the law of cause and effect is important that in our ordinary life, we take a step by step to apply it to our life.
我们首先必须要知道错误是烦恼的原因。
So first, we have to know that our mistake is the cause of our frustration and troubles.
任何事不是没有原因。
So everything happens for a reason.
无风起浪。
So without wind, there is no waves.
而毁灭是罪恶的结果。
And destruction is the result of sins.
我们要想灭离毁灭，我们就应该远离罪恶。
So if we do not want to walk the path to destruction, then we need to do our best to not commit any crimes or sins.
我们要想免于烦恼，我们就要摆脱这个错误。
So if we wish to avoid frustration and troubles, then minimize the amount of mistake that you make.
所以我们常说烦恼和错误是同在的。
So we often say that frustration, troubles coexist with mistakes.
你活在错误里，你不可能不活在烦恼。
So if you live with mistakes, then it's impossible for you not to live a life of frustration and troubles.
你没有办法不活在烦恼。
It is not possible for you to live without frustration and troubles.
罪恶与毁灭是同步的。
So, sins and destruction walk together.
当你走向罪恶的时候，同时也就是走向毁灭。
As you walk towards crimes and sins, then you are also walking down the path of destruction.
走向罪恶不可能毁掉。 毁灭的命运。
So if you commit any sins, then it's not possible to avoid the destiny of destruction.
所以我们必须常反省。
So it is necessary for us to regularly do self-reflection.
所以佛陀教我们有六度这个六波罗蜜。
So the Buddha taught us the six paramita, which we also call the six liberations.
所谓六度就是度过这个烦恼和超越这个烦恼，得到解脱的涅槃。So
the six liberation, the word liberation means to liberate ourselves from frustration, troubles, and worries.
这个度也是超度的意思。
So this liberation means also to liberate ourselves from life and death.
这个佛法是要超度我们自己。
So Buddha's teaching is to help us to liberate ourselves from life and death.
我们认为死人才需要超度。
So sometimes we think that only the dead people need liberation.
重要是要来超度我们这个活人。
actually the real purpose of Buddha's teaching is to liberate the living people.
这六波罗蜜有六种方法让我们了脱这个烦恼。
So the six paramita present us with six ways of resolving frustration and worries.
我们叫做六波罗蜜。
We call it the six paramitas.
也就是布施、持戒、忍辱、精进、禅定跟智慧。
So that will be the six paramitas are the paramitas of generosity, abiding by the precepts, forbearance, wisdom, meditative concentration, and I cannot remember the next one, the last one.
就是布施、持戒。
So that will be generosity, abiding by the precepts.
忍辱、精进。
Forbearance, putting in great effort.
忍辱就是忍的意思。
So forbearance means to tolerate.
禅定跟智慧。
And then the fifth and the sixth one is meditative concentration and wisdom.
这六波罗蜜就是大乘佛教的指南，观点的指南。
So the sixth paramita is the view of the Mahayana Buddhism.
小乘佛教的三个主要的观点。
So in Hinayana Buddhism, they have three main views.
第一个我们要观无常。
So the first of all is insight into impermanence.
So 这个也是佛教的人生观。
Actually, this is also the life view of Buddhists.
我们要观世间无常，国土为脆。
So we have to perceive the insight into the impermanence of the mortal world and the fragility of all sovereign land.
说的是无常观。
So this is the view of impermanence.
四大苦空无应无我，说的是无我观。
So the four elements are the source of all suffering, and the five skandhas teaches us that there is no independent self, and this view teaches us insight into non-self.
心是恶言，行为罪数，说的是不净观。
So our mind gives rise to incorrect intention and also give us the volition to act whether well or act with ill will, and this also teaches us insight into impurity.
这个六波罗蜜虽然有大乘小乘，可是他们的修法有点不一样。
So although whether it's Mahayana Buddhism or Hinayana Buddhism, they both practice the precepts. However, how they go about practicing it is a little bit different.
这个大乘的六波罗蜜，第一就是要布施波罗蜜。
So the first paramita in Mahayana Buddhism is the generosity paramita.
这个布施。 有财布施、法布施、无畏施。
So generosity could be the giving of the Dharma, giving of money, or giving of fearlessness.
我们说一切布施中，法施为最。
And we say that of all the acts of generosity, the giving of the Dharma is the foremost.
也就是说，我们要强调法的布施。
So, which means we want to emphasize the giving of the Dharma.
好像现在在家戒的期间,
For example, during this festive season,
很多人都会互相赠送礼品。
So, many people, practice giving presents to each other, one another.
当然，最好的礼品就是这个法，送给人这个法布施。
And the best present that you can give to anyone is the Dharma teaching.
好像你今天上线到禅宁洗尘。
For example, this evening you are online with us in chanting clean dust.
如果你得到受益呢，你也把这个法布施给你旁边认识的人。
So if this is beneficial to you, you can also pass on this gift of the Dharma to those besides you, around you.
不一定只是在钱财。
So generosity is not only the giving of money.
你做一个动作就是布施。
So any kind of action that you do can be a present for other people.
你动动手就是在布施。
Just moving your finger is also acts of generosity.
我现在看到有很多人在上线很认真在听法。
So now coming online, and we can see some of our fellow practitioners with their video switch on, and some of them very sincerely place their palms together. And this is also a giving act of generosity for all the fellow practitioners.
所以每个人都可以做到这个布施，做到完美就是布施波罗蜜。
So everyone can practice this generosity paramita, and when your act of generosity is complete, then that is a paramita.
下面我们讲施波罗蜜，就是持戒，就是佛陀重要的教导。So
we've talked about the generosity paramita. The next is the abidance by the precept paramita.
在小镇的佛教。 要你保持清净的心，不断的修行。
So the precepts paramita is a very important teaching of the Buddha. And in Hinayana Buddhism, they practice this keeping of the precepts to keep a pure mind.
若经常保持清净的修行，有一天也能达到涅槃的解脱。
So if you practice sincerely and you practice strongly, then one day you can also attain nirvana.
也就是摆脱痛苦,
which means liberating yourself from pain and suffering.
戒律就像一道围墙保护你的幸福。
So precept is like a wall of fence. It protects your peace and joy.
免造恶业。
And it prevents you and from committing any bad karma.
大正的戒律是相同的。
So Mahayana, we also practice the abidance of the precept.
但在修持上稍微有点不一样。
But how we go about practicing abidance by the precept is quite different.
在大乘的佛教的修行中，持戒不是为了自己修。
In Mahayana Buddhism, when we abide by the precepts, we are not doing it for ourselves.
而是为了帮助他人而持戒。
We do it in order to help other people.
更要知道什么时候是开遮持办，要懂持戒的精神。
So we know we need to know when to open and close the precept. We need to know when to do a tight precept practice and when to loosen our precept practice.
所以戒律是非常重要。
So keep abidance by the precept is very important.
就如路牌指示正确的方向。
Because keeping by the precepts point us to the right direction.
如果没有这些戒律，就很难行找正道。
Without all these precepts, it's difficult to walk on the correct path.
同时不要执着戒律。
At the same time, don't be attached to the precepts.
戒律本身没有好没有坏。
The precepts by itself is not good.
关在是在于我们的出发点。
The important thing is why do we do it?
故此，如果你只是保持菩萨心，
and if you only keep a bodhisattva mind,
比如说你需要圆融的方便才能够帮助其他人。
Sometimes in order to be accommodative, and we use expedient means.
例如你在 树林散步的时候,
say for example, you are taking a walk in the forest.
有一只白兔子向右边走去,
a white rabbit walked past you.
几分钟后，一个猎人到来问你有没有看见这个兔子走过。
Then a moment later, a hunter came to you and asked you, "Did you see the rabbit?"
如果你对他说出事实,
so if you tell him the truth that the rabbit has gone to the right side, then the rabbit will be killed.
如果你不肯说,
but if you don't say anything,
猎人可能会选对方向,
the hunter may choose the right direction to go after.
但是如果你说谎,
but if you tell a lie,
只是他走左边,
you say that, oh, it has gone to the left side.
你便能救了这个兔子的性命。
Then you can save the life of the rabbit.
也让猎人不照而已。
And you also prevent the hunter from making bad karma.
所以在大乘佛教中戒律不是为了自己。
So in the Mahayana Buddhism, we abide by the precepts, not for ourselves.
要保持清净无染的心。
So we don't do it for ourselves, neither do we do it in order to keep a pure mind.
是要帮助一切众生。
We do it to help all sentient beings.
我们称它为戒律。
So we call this precepts.
那戒律如何发挥它的作用来帮忙众生？
So how do we bring the precepts to life so that we can function and help all sentient beings?
用你的好与坏帮助他人。
Then use your good and bad to help others.
这就是大慈大悲的菩萨行。
So this is the great loving kindness, great compassionate Bodhisattva path.
好和坏是你真正的老师。
So good and bad are your true teacher.
如果你断除你的审查的心，没有好和坏。
So if you cut off your checking mind, then there's no good, no bad.
没有善恶。
No kindness and no evil.
宇宙的一切是你的好友和老师。
Everything in this universe is your good friend, is your teacher.
那你就得自在无碍。
Then you are at ease without hindrance.
这就是你如何可以找到你的正道。
This is how you find your correct path.
如果你明白这个正道。
And if you understand the correct path.
那只是向前。 去做,
then only go straight and just do it.
不要执着路旁的任何东西,
don't be attached to anything.
只是直径,
only go straight.
我们每天都会发四弘誓言,
so every day we make the four great vows.
第一就是大愿, 就是众生无边誓愿度。
And the first of these four great vows is sentient beings are numberless. We vow to save them all.
这个愿很明显地表现出佛对众生的慈悲心。
So this vow clearly shows us the Buddha's compassion for all sentient beings.
这也是指导我们的行为和见性。
So this is also guiding us in correct behavior, correct action, and in order to attain enlightenment.
不只是为自己。
So, but it's not just for ourselves.
而是为所有的众生。
It is for all sentient beings.
这意味着无论是好的心情还是坏的心情。
That means whether it's a good situation or a bad situation.
无论是好的处境还是不好的处境。
Or, you know, good or bad conditions.
我们只会尽力去帮助一切众生。
We only do our best to help all sentient beings.
这是不断的赏识的心。
This is also what we call try mind.
不只是在这一生中。
Not only this life.
而且生生世世常行这个菩萨道。
Life after life, always practice on the great Bodhisattva path.
得到开悟，帮忙其他的人离苦得乐。
Attain enlightenment and help everyone liberate themselves from suffering and obtain true peace and joy.
这就是精进，也叫做精进波罗蜜。
So this is also called effort or the effort paramita.
还有一个忍辱波罗蜜。
So we also have the forbearance paramita.
忍辱的意思是说安忍。
So forbearance means equanimity.
安忍的意思是说 你能够心安，任何处境你心都能够安。
So equanimity means in any kind of situation, your mind is always calm.
现在的冠病的疫情呢， 让全球人都不安。
So with this COVID-19 pandemic, the humans all over Earth is not at peace, not calm.
反正处境我们还是要生活。
But whatever is the situation, we have to live.
我们不能够逃避任何问题。
We cannot escape from any problems.
每样事情都有它的原因。
Everything happens for a reason.
我们不要制造任何因，我们不需要承担任何果。
If we do not make any cause, we do not need to bear any effect.
我告诉我们住的这世界就是娑婆世界。
So the Buddha taught us that this world that we live in is the samsara.
娑婆世界是不完美的世界。
So the samsara world is intrinsically imperfect.
所以我们需要忍耐。
Thus, we need forbearance.
好的过东西也会过去。
All good situations will soon go away.
不好的也会过去。
Bad things will also go away.
重要，我们要努力的学习，然后不断的面对问题，我们就是可以解决任何困难的问题。
So the most important thing is to keep a sincere and strong practice, then we can face any kind of situation, and we can deal with and manage all kinds of situations.
不管任何处境，我们心要安。
So whatever is the situation, our mind is at peace.
当你的心安的时候，你的心就好像虚空般的清明。
And when you have this peace of mind, then your mind is clear like the vast space.
任何处境出现，你都不会乱，也不会恐慌，也能够得到安定。
Then any kind of situation appear, you will not be confused.
所以我们就有这个禅定波罗蜜。
Then that is also the meditative concentration paramita.
只是保持你的心清明如镜子一般的。
So only keep your mind clear like the piece of mirror.
任何问题出现，只是反照得很清楚。
Any kind of problems appear, it just reflect the problem clearly back to you.
镜子呢，只是反照，它不会留恋任何东西。
The mirror will only reflect, it will not try to grab onto anything.
一切你所看到的、所听到的、所闻到的、所嗅到、感触到跟想到的任何事物都非常清楚。
So whatever that you see, you hear, you smell, you taste, you touch, you think, all this are very clear to you.
所有的事物都是真理。
All things are the truth.
这就是三摩地。
And this is samadhi.
也就是禅定。
This is also meditative concentration.
那许多人认为禅修是不断的坐禅，保持不动的状态。
So many people think that meditation practice, Chan meditation practice means, oh, you know, we must do sitting meditation and we must not move.
我们必须用功修行，只能坐住不动。
We can only keep a strong practice and we cannot move.
那么我会得到三摩地。
Then this way I can get samadhi.
这样的用功不好也不坏。
So this kind of practice is not good, not bad.
但是真正的禅修不仅是坐在蒲团上。
But true Chan meditation practice is not just sitting on the cushion.
真正禅修是实践在我们的日常生活中。
True Chan meditation practice is our everyday life.
当有的人认为三摩地的状态能够使禅修变得特别
，But some people think that you know the state of samadhi can make something special out of Chan meditation.
因此，禅修和日常生活就分开了。
Actually, Chan meditation practice is never separate from our ordinary life.
就不能发挥作用。
Then, we need to bring Chan meditation practice into our life.
就是懂得运作。
Which means we know how to function every day.
真正的三摩地是时时刻刻保持如如不动的心。
So, true samadhi means moment to moment, keep an unmoving mind.
无论是行住坐卧。
So, whether you are walking, sitting,Lying down or keeping still.
做任何东西，只是去做。
Anything that you are doing, only just do it.
当你开车的时候，
when you're driving.
只是开车, 清清楚楚,
only just drive very clearly.
啊, 红灯, 停, 一灯过,
red light, stop. Green light, go.
当你洗碗碟, 只是洗碗碟,
when you're doing your dishes, only wash the dishes.
你不会埋怨, 哎呀, 你们只会吃, 不会洗。
You won't grumble, aiya, these people, they only know how to eat, they don't know how to do the dishes.
啊, 所以禅定呢, 只是去做, 在我们的日常生活。
So meditative concentration means only just do it in our everyday life.
这就是三摩地, 这个并不特别。
So samadhi is not special.
啊, 当你继续的用功, 你的精进的修行就会得到无上的智慧。
So if you continue with a sincere and strong practice, then your effort will help you attain, will bear fruits.
无上的智慧。
Then you will attain the utmost wisdom.
我们叫做禅波罗蜜。
Then we call this the Chan Paramita.
换句话说, 智慧是治疗无知的药。
In another word, wisdom is the medicine for ignorance.
当你保持清明的心,
when you keep a clear mind,
随着这样的修持的经验,
and through such the experience of such practice,
啊, 智慧就会自然显现出来,
then wisdom will reveal itself to you.
在佛教的许多传统中,
so in many traditions of Buddhism,
重点在于训练清净的心。
They often emphasize a pure mind.
远离烦恼。
In order to keep away from frustration and troubles.
因此这些佛教总是教导人观不净。
So this kind of Buddhism always teach people to perceive with insights into impurity.
你必须看到一切都是不净,
so you need to perceive that everything is impure.
然后才能去除软浊,
that is the only way to eradicate yourself from all taintedness.
这样才证入清净的心,
then you can attain a pure mind.
但大乘的佛教和禅宗的教导说,
however, Mahayana Buddhism and Zen teaches,
要进步要有这个清明心,
a further step is necessary. We need to have clear mind.
如果你不知道那种思维,
if you don't make any thinking,
你的心就如虚空般的清明,
then your mind is clear like the vast space.
这意味着你的心已超越了净和不净。
This means that your mind has gone beyond pure or impure.
最初不存在的纯净和不纯净的东西。
So it doesn't have anything that is pure or impure.
纯净的心和清明心,
so pure mind and clear mind,
两者的体验操作是不一样的。
These two experiences, they function differently.
如果你有个孩子,
so say for example you have a child,
你的孩子的心很单纯纯净无染。
So this child has a very simple and pure mind.
他对世界没有很大的想法。
So this child doesn't have many ideas and opinions about the world.
也没有任何执着和欲望。
And it doesn't have any attachments and desires.
孩子的想法总是很简单。
So a child thinking is always very simple.
当我饿了，我会吃。
When I'm hungry, I eat.
我累了，就去睡觉。
When I'm tired, I sleep.
这是一个很简单的想法，非常的纯净。
So this is a very simple way of thinking, very, very pure.
没有污染。
No taintedness.
原始的佛教传统强调这一点。
So in the olden days, tradition of Buddhism emphasized this point.
我们必须清除心中的染浊。
However, we need to be clear of the impurity that exists in our mind.
并回归原本的清净,
and return to our original purity.
啊, 这种教导不好, 也不坏。
So this kind of teaching is not good, not bad.
啊, 但体验本来清净的心很重要。
Yes, to experience your original purity is important.
但是你还需要进一步。
But you need to make another step further.
进一步是必要的。
Take a step further is necessary.
如果你只保持清净的心，智慧就不会增长。
If you only keep a pure mind, then wisdom will not grow out in you.
就如这个孩子。
Just like this child.
他的心非常的单纯，清净。
The mind is very simple, very pure.
他的思想没有被欲望所染污。
His thinking has not yet been tainted by any kind of desires.
但是仅仅用一个单纯的心是不足够。
But just a pure mind is not enough.
这种单纯清净的心如何帮助他人？
This kind of pure mind, how to help others with it?
如果孩子的母亲病得很严重。
See, for example, the child's mom has fallen ill.
或者遇到问题，或者受伤了。
Or she faced some problem and she's hurt.
这孩子将无法应对这种情况。
Then this child would not be able to deal with this kind of situation.
同样，当有人遇到苦难时，
At the same time, when people face suffering,
或者在某种情况上有明确的解决的方法，
Or they face some situation where there's no clear-cut solution.
因此，拥有智慧是非常重要的。
Therefore, it's very important to have wisdom.
以清明的心，
With a clear mind.
在任何的情况下保持正确的运作。
In any kind of situation, keep correct function.
帮助一切众生。
Help all sentient beings.
这是圆满的智慧，超越好与坏。
This is the perfect completion of wisdom. It's beyond good or bad.
软与静。
It's beyond purity or impurity.
这是非常重要的一点。
This is a very important point.
因此，你必须时刻保持清明的心，发挥作用。
Thus, moment to moment, keep a clear mind and bring this clear mind into your life actively.
以帮助一切众生。
And then help all sentient beings.
一切你所看到的、所听到的、尝到的、接触到的、感受到的事物呢，都非常清楚。
Then everything that you see, you hear, you smell, you taste, you touch, you feel, everything is very clear.
所有的事物都是真理。
All things are the truth.
一切如是。
Everything is just like this.
天空蓝的。
Sky is blue.
树是绿的。
Trees are green.
狗在汪汪叫。
Dog bark woof woof.
糖是甜的。
Sugar is sweet.
肚子饿，然后怎么办？
So if you're hungry, what do you do?
你累了，做些什么呢？
When you're tired, what do you do?
一个受苦的人来到你身边，你能做什么？
When someone is suffering and they come to you, what can you do?
那你就要发挥你的智慧，怎么样去正确的运作，建立正确的关系。
Then you need to bring your wisdom into your life.
这个不是很复杂。
This is not complicated.
只是去做了，我们本有的智慧就显现。
Only just do it and your original wisdom will reveal itself.
所以下面我们讲到怎么样用功的方法，用功有蓝和意两种。
So next we'll talk about how to practice. And we say that to practice, there are two kinds of advantages and difficulties.
一个是出用心的蓝和意。
So the first is the advantages and difficulties faced by beginner practitioners.
二是老用心的蓝和意。
The second type is the difficulties and advantages faced by seasoned practitioners.
出用心的人，一个蓝的是偷心不死。
So for beginner practitioner, one of the difficulty they face is endless craving and checking.
出用心的通病就是妄想习气放不下。
So a common affliction among all beginner practitioners is that they cannot put down their delusory thinking and their heavy energy.
无明共高极度障碍。
So their ignorant and their arrogant and their own jealousy hinder their practice.
贪嗔痴爱。
So they crave for love. They also have anger, desire, and ignorance.
好吃懒做是非人我.
So they are also lazy and they are also gluttonous. And they differentiate between self and others, creating dispute and conflicts.
装满一大肚皮,哪能和道相应?
So their stomach is bloated with all these afflictions. And how can this kind of people have the volition to keep practicing on the path?
或有些是公子而出生的,
and some are from well-to-do family.
习气不忘,
they can never cut through their heavy energy.
半点骨头吃不得,哪能用功办到呢?
They cannot take even a little bit of hardship, so how can these people practice?
可是他就没有想想,
they have never,
释迦牟尼佛是怎么样出家的?
So they had never thought about the social status of the Shakyamuni Buddha before he became a monastic.
或者有些人懂了几个字就行章招妓,
and some people, they are well learned, they are very academically knowledgeable, so they will know how to use the teachings of the ancient teachers.
把古人的言记做解会,
so they will take the teachings of the ancient teachers and apply their own understanding on it.
还自以为了不起,深大我慢,
and even though they are only doing that, but they think very highly of themselves and they become very arrogant.
一做一场大病就叫苦连天.
So if they, when they face a big illness, they fall very ill, then you can see them becoming very fragile and very weak.
或是腊月三十到来就手忙脚乱.
Or on the last day of their life, they scramble about.
真凭自己一点也用不着才悔之不及.
So all their dry understanding that they have amassed in their life cannot help them, and at this point they will be full of remorse.
而有点道心的人又摸不着一个下手的地方.
And those with a stronger practice mind, they just cannot get a hang of the practice.
或有害怕妄想除又除不了.
So some are, you know, fearful of their own delusory thought, and they cannot get rid of it.
终日烦烦恼恼，自觉的业重深重.
So day in, day out, you know, they are irritable, and they are very troubled, and they blame their own karmic hindrances.
因此退次这个道心.
And as time passes, their volition to practice will subside.
或者要和妄想拼命,
and there are some who want to fight to the end with their own delusory thinking.
纷纷提起招掌挺胸睁眼.
So you can see them clenching their fists in anger, and then their chest will be, you know, up and erect, and then they will stare into the space.
想煞有绝世要和妄想结死战.
So they take things too seriously, and they want to have a life and death duel with their own delusory thinking.
哪知道妄想是拼不了的.
Of course, you cannot fight to the end with your own delusory thinking.
弄得吐血发狂.
And instead, it will have the effect of causing some internal injury or causing some aesthetic behaviors.
或者有怕 落空,哪知道早已生出鬼.
So some are fearful of befalling into emptiness, but that is already practicing on the wrong path.
空也空不掉.
So they cannot get rid of emptiness.
悟也悟不来.
And neither can they attain enlightenment.
或者有将心求悟.
So where else, some others have a, you know, strong craving for enlightenment.
知道求悟道想成佛都是一个大妄想.
So actually craving for attaining enlightenment and attaining Buddhahood is itself a big mistake.
沙非范本.
So, you know, no matter how long you boil the sand, it can never become rice.
直到离年马叶也决定 不得悟。
No matter how long you crave, you will not get enlightenment.
我有碰到一两支静香的，就生欢喜。
And some experience this stillness and quietude during one or two incense stick of sitting.
那仅此盲眼乌龟钻木口。
Actually, it's only like a blind turtle that managed to find the hole in the wood to crawl in.
偶然碰着不是实在的功夫。
It is just by chance, it's not true practice.
欢喜魔早已僵住心了。Yet
the monster of delight and elation has already controlled their mind.
或者有的静中觉得清清静静很好过。
And then some, you know, they experience this quietude and calmness while doing sitting meditation and they really enjoy it.
动中又不行了。But
you ask them to do something, you know, get into action, they cannot maintain this mind frame.
因此避开喧闹，只找清静的地方。
Thus, they avoid the hustle and bustle of life and they seek solitude and quietude.
其实这已经做了动静两魔王的建树。By
practicing this way, they have already become the relative of the monster of action and the monster of quietness.
诸如此类很多很多。So
there are many examples of such afflictions.
初用功摸不到路头，实在是困难。
So for beginners, practitioners, if they cannot get a hang of the practice, it is indeed a difficult matter.
有结无照，这散乱不能落堂。
So if there is some realization but no insight, then they cannot say that their practice has been completed.
有照无结，又坐在死水里泡沙。
However, if they have some insights but no realization of their true nature, then that is like soaking in stagnant water.
那么初用心得意又在哪儿呢?
Then what are the advantages faced by beginners, practitioners?
放下来，单提一念。
That is, put it all down with one-pointedness of the mind. Just do it.
用功虽硕难，但摸到路头就很容易了。
So although we say that yes, it's not easy to practice, but once you get the hang of it, it is easy.
那什么是初用心的意义呢?
Then what is the advantages faced by beginners practitioner?
其实没有什么窍门。
Actually, there are no special techniques.
放下来就是。
Only put it all down.
放下个什么呢?
Put what down?
放下一切无明烦恼。
Put down all ignorance and troubles.
那怎么样才放下?
Then how to put it down?
大家也送过往生者。So
I'm sure everyone has sent off dead people.
你是做妈妈，那个死尸几句，他也不动气。And
if you, you know, scold the dead corpse, it will not be angry.
打他几拳，他也不还手。And
if you punch the dead corpse a few times, he will not hit you back.
平时好打无名的也不打了。So
usually when they're alive, if they were ignorant and easily provoked, now they will not be provoked at all.
平时好名利的也不要了。And
when they're alive, they crave for fame and some gains and benefits. Now they don't want anything.
平时诸多习杂也没有了。And
those who have a lot of bad habits when they're alive, now they don't have a single thing.
什么也不分别，什么也放下了。So
they will not be differentiating anything. They will have put down everything.
诸位同参。So
fellow practitioners,
我们这个躯壳子一口气不来，就是一具死尸。So
this empty shelf of ours, with the last breath and not coming back anymore, is just a dead corpse.
我们所以放不下，只因为我们把这个躯壳看得太重了。So
the reason why we cannot put it all down is because we take this empty shell too seriously.
所以才生出人我是非。Thus,
this gives rise to differentiating between self and others, causing disputes and conflicts.
爱憎取舍。Craving
for love, causing hatred, and then including and excluding. So if you truly know that this empty shell is just a dead corpse,
不去宝贵它,
don't take it as some treasure.
根本不把它看作是我,
don't even take it as my body, my empty shell.
还有什么放不下呢?
What else can you not put down?
只要放得下二六十种不论行住坐卧,
if you can put it all down at all times, whether you are sitting, standing, lying down, or keeping still.
动静闲往通身内外,
whether you are busy or idling, whether you are just being still or in active movement, inside and outside, your whole entire being.
只是一个一念,
only just keep one great doubt.
平平和和不断地移下去,
steadily, calmly, keep this great doubt.
不杂丝毫一念,
completely devoid of all other thoughts.
一句话头如取天常见,
one sentence of the Huadu is like your heavenly sword.
这个东西障碍你修行,
anything that hinder your practice, just chop it off.
不怕什么妄想,
not in fear of any delusions.
有什么打的玄窗,
then what else can distract you?
哪个有去分别动, 分别静呢?
Then what need is there to differentiate between being in action or just keeping quiet and still?
哪个气氛浊有浊空?
What need is there to differentiate between emptiness and existence?
如果怕妄想又加重妄想,
the fear of delusion in itself is a delusion.
觉清净早已不清净,
so wanting purity is already impure.
怕浊空早已落在有中,
and being fearful of befalling into emptiness, actually that is already an attachment on existence.
想成佛已经入了魔道,
wishing to attain Buddhahood, you have already practiced on the path of evil.
所谓饮水搬柴无非妙道,
so in Zen we have a teaching that whether it's carrying water or chopping wood, that is our practice.
昨天种地,
so whether plowing the land or working in the farm, that is Chan meditation.
不是一天盘起推来打坐才算用功办道.
So keeping a sincere and strong practice doesn't mean that you need to sit on some cushion in a certain sitting posture.
以上我们讲了很多, 我们刚刚讲了很多,
so we just talk a lot.
时间过了,
so time has actually passed.
我们下周, 星期五会再进行, 刚好今年1月1号。
Okay, so actually next Friday is New Year's Day, and it's tradition in Chanling that we have a New Year evening Dharma talk every year.
希望大家一起来学习。
So we'll continue next Friday evening, and Shifu hope that everyone will come and learn Buddha's teaching.
真的新的一年, 日日好好日,
and in the new year, every day will be a good day.
时时好好时,
all times are good times.
年年好好年,
every year is a good year.
众生无边誓愿度,
sentient beings are numberless, we vow to save them all.
烦恼无尽誓愿断,
delusions are endless, we vow to cut through them all.
法门无量誓愿解,
the teachings are infinite, we vow to learn them all.
佛道无上誓愿成,
the Buddha way is inconceivable, we vow to attain it.
谢谢大家.
Thank you everyone. So see you on Friday, 星期五晚上见.